If you ever found yourself standing in front of your Kyocera 4 Series, wondering how to get it to do what you need, you are in the right place. Today, I'm going to walk you through the essentials of navigating the Kyocera 4 Series control panel. By the end, you'll feel confident using this machine for all your copying, scanning, and faxing needs. Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Copy and welcome to the Copier Channel. Now, let's dive into everything you need to know about the Kyocera 4 Series control panel. First up, let's talk about the home screen. This is your control center, where all the action happens. Right at the top, you'll see a row of icons for copy, scan, fax, and more. These are your most frequently and used functions, and they are front and center to save you time. One of the coolest features here is the customizable widgets. This allows you to personalize your home screen by adding shortcuts to the functions you use the most. For example, if you frequently scan to a specific email, you can create a shortcut for that right on your home screen. No more digging through menus. All right, let's move on the basic operations. These are the bread and butter of any multifunction printer. Copy function. Making a copy should be straightforward. Start by placing your document on the glass or in the document feeder. On the home screen, tap the copy button. From here, you can adjust a variety of settings like color versus black and white, duplexing, that's double-sided printing, and paper size. Want to make the text darker or lighter? There's a setting for that too. Once you got everything set, just hit start and let the machine do its magic. Scan to email folder. Scanning is another essential task, especially when you need to send documents quickly. To scan to email, tap the send button on the home screen. You'll be prompted to enter the recipient's email address, either by typing it or selecting it from the preloaded address book. Before you scan, you can adjust settings like resolution and file format, PDF, JPEG, etc. Then just press start and your document will be on its way. The process for scanning to a folder is similar. Just choose the folder destination instead of an email. Fax it up. Yes, people still fax. And if you need to send one, here's how. Tap the fax button on the home screen. You can enter the fax number manually or select it from your address book. If you have multiple pages, load them onto the document feeder. Double check your settings like resolution and cover page option, then press start. The Kyocera will confirm once the fax is sent successfully. Now, let's get into some advanced features that can really streamline your workflow. User authentication. If your office uses different user accounts, you'll need to log in before you can access certain features. The Kyocera 4 Series supports several logging methods, including PIN codes, ID cards, or even network authentication. Logging in not only secures your document, but also allows you to save personalized settings. Simply tap the login icon, enter your credentials, and you're in. Job queue management. Ever had a print job get stuck in the queue? It happens, but the Kyocera make it easy to manage. Tap the job queue button to see all current or pending print jobs. You can prioritize urgent jobs, pause them, or cancel them altogether. Maintenance alerts. No one likes maintenance surprises, so the Kyocera gives you a heads up with maintenance alerts. If you see a low toner warning or a paper jam alert, don't panic. The control panel will guide you through what needs to be done. For example, if toner is low, the machine will show you which cartridge needs replacing and how to do it. If there is a paper jam, the panel will display exactly where it is and how to clear it, step by step. Network connectivity. If the printer loses its connection to the network, you can troubleshoot right from the control panel. Start by checking the Wi-Fi settings to ensure the printer is connected to the correct network. If you're using a wire connection, make sure the cable is securely plugged in. If all else fails, a quick reboot of the printer and the router usually does the trick. Energy saving modes. Want to save on electricity? The Kyocera has several energy saving modes. You can set the machine to enter sleep mode after a certain period of inactivity or even power down completely. To adjust these settings, go to the System menu, then select Energy Saving Options. It's a simple way to cut costs and be a little more eco-friendly. Language and display settings. If English isn't your preferred language, or if you just want to make the screen easier to read, head to the language and display settings. Here, you can choose from multiple languages and adjust the display contrast and brightness to suit your preferences. And there you have it, a comprehensive guide to navigating the Kyocera 4 Series control panel. With these tips and tricks, you'll be able to make the most of all the powerful features this machine has to offer, whether you are copying, scanning, faxing, or just managing your print jobs. The Kyocera 4 Series is designed to make your life easier. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe for more tech tips and tutorials. And remember, you can worry less with AIS.